you want?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Vicar Max.
That Reginald.
What are you doing on Monarch? I thought scienticians ain't welcome here.
Scientician?
Haven't you heard? Everyone's welcome here. It's a fucking worker's paradise. But you wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Oops.
Never worked a day in your miserable life. You're just a parasite, living off my goodwill. Well, guess what? My goodwill's exhausted, along with my temper.
I'm always up for senseless violence. Please, violence, please proceed. This guy doesn't look much like a scholar, Max. You care to explain?
This is the guy who told me about the book while we were in prison. I lied about finding a scholar.
Hey.
But I don't care about any of that anymore. I just want to inflict massive amounts of pain on this guy.
Why'd you lie to me?
I couldn't risk you not bringing me here.
Hey, brother.
It sounds like you have things to work out between you. I'll just be on my way.
Max, you should have told me about this.
Would you have brought me all this way just to watch me beat the life out of a greasy ex-convict if I had?
No. Probably depend on my mood on that particular day.
Exactly. Feel free to turn away if the sight of blood offends you. Now, where were we? Oh, that's right. I was about to beat you. Severely.
What is that going to prove?
Wait!
Or achieve?
I know who can translate the book for you.
It's too late for that. I threw away my life chasing fairy tales. Will punishing you fix any of that? Of course not. But by law, it will make me feel a whole lot better.
Max, stop. It's not too late. Maybe the answer you've been looking for is in that book.
Okay. Talk, Reggie.
It was stolen from some sort of expert on philosophism. Weird hermit lady on Scylla. My father used to deliver supplies to the mining outpost there.
Weird hermit? Sounds kind of flimsy to me.
It's true. My father collected some extra bits on the side by diverting some of the supplies to the gal. The way he told it, he thought the book looked valuable, so he took it. Couldn't find any buyers when it turned out to not only be French, but banned as well.
Hmm. What do you say, Vicar?
Fine. We've got more important things to do anyway.
Hey, I just want to thank you for saving my life.
Saving your life? That's a bit of exaggeration.
Exaggeration? Has the Vicar told you what he did to old Lem? He's still eating through a tube, last I heard.
Lem?
Look, what I may or may not have done to some degenerate during a prison brawl is old news. I'd rather not discuss it.
Hmm.
Hey, I just want to thank you for saving my life.
Can't steal any of your stuff. I mean, if we're not going to kill you, at least we should steal some of your stuff. Alright, never mind. I got stuck on a log or something. Or a sandbar.
There's something weighing on my mind.
Let's get out of the water. I'll talk to you about it.
I want to thank you for talking some sense into me back there with Chaney. It has been a long time since I gave in to my violent enthusiasm.
I already know why. Yet, I have two options to ask him anyway. Never mind that. Why did you feel the need to lie about Chaney?
You're right. I owe you an apology. I've been so obsessed for so long, I couldn't see anything else. You offered me a place on your crew, friendship, and I used you to get to Chaney.
Sure did.
And even then, you saved me from myself. I don't know if I could live with myself had I gone through with it. You owe me nothing, I know, but I'm begging your forgiveness.
I understand, Max. You all get a little obsessed sometimes. All's forgiven.
Thank you. I promise I'll be nothing but truthful from this point forward.
Okay, I'll hold you to that. What's it like? What was it like being in prison?
Oh, exactly as you'd imagine. Can't say I enjoyed the stint. It did provide me with plenty of time to think. The way I see it, the universe was snapping me back to where I needed to be. You stray too far from the course of your destiny, the world will try to correct for it.
All right. Let's move on then. So, the scholar turned out to be someone else entirely, an ex-con man Max met in prison, but through Reginald you're able to learn that the journal was originally the property of a philosophist who rusticates in a life of hermitage on Scylla. Vicar Max wants to talk to this hermit, not surprisingly. Alright, shall we check out this waterfall? We need to just go in the water. For some reason. Stand back, guys. I wonder if there's any more that we can't see. Why was that put there? Oh. I'm sorry. You guys all right? I didn't realize you were standing so close to it. So there's a hidden cache of stuff here. Sweet. A plasma launcher. Hello, grip. This vented Mark III helmet. Sweet. Pretty good find. I thought that was a camera for a second. I mean, it kind of looks like it could be a camera mounted there, but actually it looks like a power battery pack for the light. Well, that was cool. Except for me hurting you guys. Sorry about that. So, what is this?
For the price, I expected a larger cot.
For the price, I expected a larger cot.
You too?
Ain't looking for trouble, no.
Oh, you're the different one. These two are the sheep. What is this place? There's an upstairs ramp.
They do not produce derelict entertainment such as this on Byzantium, I assure you.
Yeah, I assure you.
Booze like this leads to two things. Bumping uglies and brawling.
And what are you in the mood for?
My bit carts are fully loaded and ready to be spent. Bring on the recreation.
Good for you. Workbench.
Ain't in the mood to chat.
No, huh?
What are you looking at?
A fiend. A vile fiend of a man. Another fiend. So that's my bits, 262, I think. Yes. They wouldn't see me, right? If I close this door and crouch down, what's in this room? Answer, nothing. I'm nobody. There are things. I can have at it though. Another ID cartridge. I actually want to sell this stuff now. Instead of breaking it down. For a second I got scared. I thought someone was sitting there. Tuna of the Deep. I don't have a discount, or it doesn't say, I don't know. Oh, this is buying. What is this stuff? It's expensive. Changes to corrosion. Okay, yeah, I do have those. They're very expensive to buy. I'm glad we find them. Places. Just get rid of two of these. Keep one. Melee weapon mod. This is mine attributes plus one. Just like that one. So now, oh, I still gotta sell this stuff. Plasma launcher. $273. 60. I'm gonna get rid of the Montag then and keep this thing. A plasma launcher. Facing an unruly mob, hold your head high as the Jotch plasma launcher lobs its plasma balls high. These mobs will disperse faster than you can say designated curfew. Try the new overcharge feature too. So we'll get rid of the Montag. So now we can buy heavy ammo. Ooh, we can buy 100 here. Sweet. That's pretty awesome. We have a good amount of heavy ammo. Pretty happy about that. There's more to this building, though, isn't there? Yeah, right, there's this upstairs. Hi.
In the mood to chat. What are you looking at?
A thug. A simple thug. You know what? What's back here? Excuse me. There's bound to be something interesting back here. Maybe. Really? Nothing back here? Usually you're rewarded for exploring like this. Alright. Let's check out the upstairs. I don't know what this building is. Very curious to find out. Oh, we can put our... We can call our ship here. Yeah, remote landing. Okay. I see no need for it right now. Here's another. Does this terminal fulfill the same purpose? No. Fallbrook Shipping and Receiving. Authorized users, please enter your authorization code. Everyone else, if I catch you using this thing, I'm going to tie steel to your feet and throw you in a sulfur pool. Catherine. Alright, well. Hope Catherine doesn't do that to us. Let's access the shipping manifests. The most recent manifests. Outgoing. Anti-Cleo perishables. Okay, we got parcels. Going to different outposts. Department of Engineering and Agriculture. Spacer's Choice Perishables. Department of Sanitation, Department of Security. Purchase request UDL-2007. Request Department of Agriculture. Offer. Stuff really doesn't mean anything to me. Supplies delivery. Register supplies. Rizzo's Purple Berry Bunch, 200 kilograms. Doc Rocket's Chocolasteroids, 175 kilograms. Spacer's Choice Salt Tuna, 175 kilograms. And CMP Near Maple Syrup, 225 kilograms. Interesting. I don't know what we could use that for, though. That's overlooking where we just were. Okay. I haven't picked up anything else. Can we afford it? No. Yeah, that would hurt if we just fell down there. Okay, I think we're done looking around, believe it or not. We'll go talk to Catherine.
You'd think folks were pissing in the alleyways as bad as it stinks.
Hmm.
Oh, they are.
They are.
So that puddle I stepped in? That wasn't beer.
Oh, jeez. People don't seem to like it here. I don't know why they are here. I guess there's no alternative. Catherine! I need some money right away. Hi.
Keep walking, Rung Leech.
You guys need better lines than that.
My bet's on Citation in the autoloader races.
Okay. Wesley Alexander, anti-up vendor.
Ain't looking for trouble. Nope.
Ain't looking for trouble. No.
Hey, Niles. There, Terminator. Glad you showed up to take care of those mantis swarms.
Oh, yeah. I
hate those fucking things.
I remember you.
You don't look like a smuggler nor a dandy. Catherine sent you back here? On second thought, it's best if I don't know. What's your order?
She didn't send me. Nelson Mason gave me a voucher for a free drink at the Ante Up.
This is the Ante Up, all right, but we don't serve drinks. Hate to break it to you, but Nelson Mason's a con man.
What?
Try Yvonne upstairs if you're looking for a swill.
Got any Glacial Age whiskey?
No, I don't have any. Ugh. If it's only a drink you're after, the full bar's upstairs. This here's the Ante Up, where you place your bets.
What can I bet on?
Toss ball, autoloader races, card games, you name it. I ain't picky. And neither is Catherine. We'll both break your legs if you lose, then shirk on paying.
Okay. Bye. Nice people.
Keep walking, Rundage.
She's in there. Let's go look upstairs.
What are you looking at?
A thug with an ugly mug. Tipsy Sprat vendor.
For the price, I expected a larger cot.
There's actually no cots here.
Hello? I need a refill. Oh, pardon. You don't work here.
Yeah, wrong side of the bar.
I think I'll go for a swim.
Not now, you'll jinx my luck.
Folks I never met before are my most favorite kind.
Huh.
So, what's your story?
Oh, the lip color. Nelson Mason gave me a voucher for a free drink at the Ante Up, and you're about to tell me this is not the Ante Up.
Magged another one, did he? The Ante Up's downstairs, and they don't serve drinks. Here, have a pity swill on me.
Oh, thanks. Oh, she took the voucher. It's a silly thing to ask when I already know she serves drinks. It's the strangest thing, but you know, I was frozen in space for 70 years and then one day...
Let me just stop you right there, stranger. My question, it's not one I really want an answer to. Not unless it accompanies some extra bits. Understand?
How many bits are we talking?
More than you can afford at this time.
Alright. Like a drink? Triple stout, rum and something, and iceberg aged whiskey. But she'll buy my guns and all kinds of stuff. She'll buy this back from me. I sold her own drink back to her. Hey, hey. Well, these are the cots that people were complaining about? Oh, I can't close this door? Oh, it's empty. Damn it. Alright, let's go talk to her then. Hi.
Uh-huh. You blind, little bird? Or can you not see I'm busy?
I'm blind.
Why is it every sissy pig fucker who strolls into my town expects me to smile and shout awful friendly? Welcome to Fallbrook.
I didn't expect that.
Only nugget of paradise in this entire law-forsaken land. Like a void damn advert.
Catherine, you're as welcoming as ever.
Truthfully spoken. I do aim to properly represent my aforementioned nugget of paradise.
How is that charming? Well, maybe she'd like that. If by nugget of paradise you mean piece of manty dung, then sure.
You know, I ain't heard that one before. Suppose I'll have to work harder to show you just what makes our town shine.
Well, that's better, increasing.
But first, I'll need to know what brings you, stranger. Well, I'm half listening.
Actually, I'm the fixer for your sublight problem.
Good of you to finally haul your ass over here. I wired for backup weeks ago. Got something that's gonna require special extraction from Cascadia.
I found a passcode on a corpse in Stellar Bay. I guess it grants access to the extraction site?
Found it on a corpse, huh? If you killed Lilia's agent, you get to explain it to her, not me.
He was dead when I got there.
Well, shit. I knew he'd come to a bad end one day. Still, no time for weeping and wailing. We've got a metric fuckton of bits worth of salvage just waiting for extraction.
Right, the Alta Vitae stuff that Lilia mentioned.
So you got a brain on them shoulders. Excellent. Makes my life a world easier.
Mine too.
To extract the gas, you'll need to siphon it from the lab in Cascadia into one of your ship's fuel tanks. Totally safe.
Define safe.
Meaning safe for me and my crew. Seeing as it ain't us undertaking the risk.
You kidding me?
Hold your thrusters. I ain't even got to the tricky part.
Okay.
To get to the gas, you'll need to navigate through the town, which is overrun by marauders. The lab itself has become an infested nest, crawling with mantis. You gotta fight through or figure out some other way to exterminate them. Maybe the ventilation system?
If we can get it working this time, it didn't work so well before. Remind me what Alta Vitae gas is exactly.
Do I look like one of them egghead science types? All I know is that labs use it to create plants and livestock out of local species. But it's a controlled commodity, available only to the board. So it is of high value on the dark market. So what perchance is your plan?
I'll find a way around the mantisaurs.
Clever. That's why Lilia's paying you, I take it. Now, after you clear the manti nest and reach the storage room, all that's left is to get the gas flowing into the fuel system. The task will require someone with technical skills. Or you could force it through with a plasma overload. Don't recommend that option, though, unless you want to get dead.
Plasma option sounds fun. Our resident Vicar is pretty good with computers. He could hack it.
Well, I haven't seen the system, but I feel confident saying I can split her asunder.
I'll just bet you can. Men of the cloth never do cease to amaze me. Bright as a newborn star on the outside, blackest of holes within.
Oh, man.
Once you've got our goods, take them to the groundbreaker. Lilia's fencers ought to handle the rest of it. I've marked the coordinates for you to the lab in Cascadia. On the terminal, use the passcode you got from Stellar Bay to get in.
Right.
But before you make your run, I could use a heavy helping hand regarding a local issue. For a fine fee, of course.
I might be interested.
Good. This particular matter of opportunity has been eating at me for a while now.
Has it?
There's a borscht factory on up the way, run by a man who calls himself the King. Clive Lundberg, insufferable prick. That aside, it's a business ripe for the plucking. I want it. Clear as that.
I get the feeling this is going to involve murder and mayhem.
Stars, I hope so. Clive Lundberg, the self-proclaimed Borscht King of Monarch, is swimming in profit and drowning in his ego.
Sausage King of Chicago?
He's making the only meal to be had this side of Monarch, and I'm tired of ponying up for my dinner. I want that Borscht factory, owner dead or alive. And you're the soon-to-be handsomely paid fucker who's gonna get it for me.
Certainly have a way with words. What specifically do you want me to do?
Kill him. Run him out. I don't rightly care for the details. So long as Clive knows resistance to me is costly and futile. Hit him where it hurts. In his gut or his production lines ought to make do.
Any tips on how I might get in?
If you got brass knockers, you could shoot your way through the front gate. If you don't fancy getting shot to shit, you can try asking Duncan for a disguise.
Oh, I think I have one.
Might be another way in, assuming you're courageous enough to trek the sewers. Void if I know.
Huh. Three possible ways in. Say I wanted to sabotage the factory.
Then I'd say you might care to poison the cysty pigs, doctor a few financial records, or throw a wrench in the canning machinery.
Hmm. And if I wanted to kill him?
Sometimes the simplest solution is the sweetest. I don't give a whit about the method or the means, just the end.
Okay, sounds good.
It'll be more than good when you've finished. Maybe not for Clive, but for me and you, I'm sure. Oh, and if you don't fancy going in guns blazing or crawling through a sewer pipe, see Duncan in the dry goods and sundry building. He ought to have an employee ID in that stash of illicit goods he keeps for select clientele.
Hmm.
May luck be with you, since I won't be.
We have two employee IDs, if they're the right ones.
How's Clive? I do hope you gave him my regards.
I haven't dealt with Clive yet. I haven't moved from this spot.
Won't pretend I'm not disappointed. Suppose I've no choice but to be patient. Maybe a handful of bits will spur you into quicker action.
Oh, sweet. Sandra said you know something about a corporation operating in secret on Monarch.
Might be I know something about it. Might be someone hired my crew to blind drop supplies on the Northern Bridge. Might be they sure as shit weren't pirates. Now that I consider it, I ain't heard from my delivery team in far too long. Find them for me, and I'll pay you handsomely.
Well, I certainly can't take this. It's way over. I'll check it out.
And I'll thank you kindly for it.
About the Borscht Factory.
What about it? Aside from the fact that I can smell it all the way from here.
Where can I find the factory building?
You mean you can't just follow the stench trail or the squealing bloody murder sounds of little sissy piggies? Once you're clear of the bridge, follow the river southwest. Sure, weren't no skin off my nose.
Do I want a room? That's enough for now. They've never minded me going into this stuff before. I'm gonna hack it though. I shouldn't be hacking that in front of her. That'd be a bad idea. Alright, okay, never mind.
Catherine's great, ain't she? She'll pull you out of the sulfur, so long as you don't mind being in her debt.
Efficient, clever, ruthless. I like her.
You would. Secret lab access, right? So it's right here? Oh, that's the door? Is that the door? That's the door, isn't it? Yep, that's the door leading out. Okay. Someone hired Catherine's team to make blind supply drops at the bridge north of Fallbrook. Investigating the area may lead you to the proof you need. Bridge north of Fallbrook. Not here, right? It's out. Okay. Maybe we'll duke this to Sprat Kings next. Sure, there's a lot of quests here. With the scarcity of salt tuna alternatives on Monarch, Clive Lumberg has been making a killing by operating the planet's last remaining Borst factory. Sublight wants to take the self-proclaimed Borst King of Monarch's profits for themselves and have hired you to get rid of him. Deal with Clive. You make your way to Clive Lumberg's office in the CMP factory and get him out of Sublight's way. Alternatively, search the factory for a way to sabotage Clive's operations. Catherine suggests investigating the Sisty Pig food supply, the canning machine, or the financial records. That's over here. Rat Kings.
Said you docked 3 days ago?
Give or take, it's all a bit hazy when I think back on it.
So, was Fallbrook all you'd hoped for?
Yes, no, maybe. It's no Byzantium, but that's rather the point, isn't it?
What a glowing endorsement.
I slept for the first time in months, so I'll give it that.
Okay. Sprat, 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 Sprat. Okay. Might be a quick thing, might be something more involved. But either way, I'll save that for next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one, and always, seek adventure.